Today, friends, I'm going to show you some slick tricks for evenly spacing circles around a cylinder. So let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad. You can find it at tinkercad.com. I always simply choose sign in with Google. For today's project, I'm going to start by hitting create new 3D design. Now, this was for a specific user, so we're going to use some special numbers. First, we're going to take a cylinder. I'm going to shift stretch it, and the number that we needed was 180. Of course, when you do that, I'm going to hit F to fit view. You can see it is huge. I do also know that this number needed to be 10 and press enter. Put that back in the middle. And I'm also going to maximize the sides so that it is a little bit more smooth. The user then had size 52 cylinders they were working with. So I'm going to just do Control D. I'm going to shift stretch and I'm going to type 52 and press enter. Notice it goes way over here. The height of these also needed to be set to 40. So I'm going to stretch it high and make it 40. Now to line this up, here is trick number one. We're going to do L for align. Click on this one. Of course, we want it to that back edge. And we're going to do middle. And then we're going to switch to a 5mm nudge because the user wanted it 5mm away. One click, done. Now we need 5 of these, but I got a trick that's going to do it with 10. Control D, shift nudge to move it all the way down. Select the 2, L for align. This one's the boss, and we want it to come to that edge. Of course, we click on it, do one arrow click, and you've got your 5mm in both sides. Now here comes the fun way to get 5 of these by first making 10. We're going to shift select the 2 so they're selected together. When we do Control D, we are going to rotate it, and we need to rotate it 36 degrees. I'm going to rotate it to any distance, then I'm going to type 36 in the box and let go. It snaps to the exact spot, and then if we don't click anything else, we can do Control D again and again and again to get all 10 circles. Now this is one of my favorite parts of the process. Shift select every other one. Skip, skip, skip. I'm going to make them a different color just because it's kind of cool to see. Check it out. 5 of one color, deleted. The other 5 are left, and they look exactly like the user wanted. The user did also want a size 50 in the middle. Let's do that by doing Control D. I'm going to shift stretch, type the number 50 and press enter, so that snaps it. Of course, we do need to remake that height to 40. And then I'm going to shift select the 2 circles, L for align, make the large one the boss, click and click. Bang. That is the project the user wanted. Now the user mentioned they might want these to be hollow so they could store paint or something in them. I just want to show you another trick. I'm going to delete these real quick. Not going to give you all the steps. I'm just going to show you a smart way to build these with the tube. Once again, if you do the radius of 26, that gets you that 52 that we had a minute ago. Say you set your walls to 2. Let's set the height to the 40 the user wanted, and then you can do that exact same trick, but they're already ready to hold things. I'm going to select them, L for align, make this one the boss, pick this edge here, and of course center. Let's do that one click down. There's my 5mm, Control D, nudge it back. Once again, L for align, this is the boss, and there's that edge. One click in. Now I do want to maximize these before I do the duplicate. That way I don't have to do it as many times. Now they're much more smooth. Shift select, Control D, rotate the 36 degrees, and do Control D until they complete. Once again, we just delete every other one. Shift select, shift select, shift select, shift select, and shift select. Bang. Ready to hold items just like that. So remember, this was for a user that was trying to make something. It is crazy large, so we had to use this technique. If you have a smaller item, like say we've got just a normal cylinder out here, I'll go size 60 and make it 10 high. There is another amazing tool. If you go over to the search tool and type array, A-R-R-A-Y, press enter, there is an awesome circular array. Work plane, I do want to let you know if you set it up here, it is above the work plane. I'm going to set it back down by hitting D to drop, because I'm going to cut these out. It currently has a square shape. You can change it instantly to a circle shape. There are many options here, like we can pick the number of copies. A minute ago we wanted 5, so I will switch to 5. I'm going to change the radius to 15, so now it is smaller and it'll be inside my circle. We can instantly check out the math and adjust it. I'm going to do L for align and get it to center and center. And now using this cool technique, we can walk it out where we want. Let's say I do a radius of 20. That looks pretty cool. We could go to our circle and change it to size 11. Notice if it ever pops one of these, just relax and wait again. I'm going to type that number in one more time and press enter. I do want to make it a hole, and let's select it and do Control G to group. Real quickly, I'm going to wrap this up by naming it. I'm going to just call it circles. Oh, of course, I also want to say thanks to Dingo for the question. And then before I close this array, I do want to come over here and click the little star to make it a favorite. As I wrap up, friends, I do want to highlight, I think the scratch way we solved this is better. This may not be aligned to the exact measurement that the user wanted, and also you just don't get the smooth edges that we do with the newly updated settings for the cylinder. Friends, of course, I want to say thank you to everybody that supported me via YouTube memberships. 3 different levels of support starting as low as $5, and one of my favorite benefits is you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody supporting me via Patreon. Absolutely love how that group is growing. The members area is fantastic. Of course, you can learn more with the link up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering. We'll be right back.